Welcome to the Apple Lisa Take Apart Guide. The Lisa was first introduced on January 19, 1983 at a cost of $9,995, which today is around $21,693. It was the first commercially sold personal computer to have a GUI, graphical user interface. The Lisa's CRT monitor has a resolution of 720 by 364. This model is the Lisa 2, which was released in January 1984. The Lisa 2 dropped the Twiggy floppy drives in exchange for a single 400K 3.5-inch Sony floppy drive. The maximum usable memory in the Lisa is 2 megs, which was limited by the hardware design and not the CPU. It is thought that roughly around 70,000 Lisa 2s were produced. Apple at one time offered a free upgrade for Lisa 1 owners to Lisa 2 specifications, making the Lisa 1 much rarer. To begin taking apart the Lisa, you will have to take off the back subassembly. There are two fasteners at the top. Just give it a quarter turn to the left to loosen it. Then just pull out and lift up to remove the subassembly. Now to remove the Lisa's power supply. There is a fastener for the power supply as well. Just twist it and then pull on the power supply to remove it. Now to remove the Lisa's card cage. Gently pull on the card cage to remove it. See, the motherboard has three expansion slots. The Lisa 2 motherboard has a very basic backplane. There are two RAM slots, one CPU slot, and one I/O slot, all in a parallel placement. The two RAM slots being yellow, the CPU blue, and the I/O board red. To remove the RAM boards, you will see that there are two locking mechanisms on both sides. Just simply lift up on those, and the board will slide out. You'll have to follow the same procedure to remove the other RAM board. Follow the same procedure to remove the CPU board as well as the I/O board. To remove the bezel subassembly, you will see that there are two tabs located here. Simply press on them and then pull up to remove the subassembly. Now to remove the top cover. Located in the back, underneath the top cover, there are two Phillips screws. You will have to loosen these two screws. Now simply just lift up from the back and slide forward to remove the top plate. Notice the many warning labels that are located inside where the CRT monitor is. These tell you that handling the CRT monitor is extremely dangerous and can cause electrical shock. Now to remove the disk drive assembly. You will see that there is a fastener in the front. Loosen it and then slide the whole disk drive assembly out. Once the disk drive assembly is free, there is a ribbon cable to remove. Simply unlock the tabs on both sides of the ribbon cable and pull up on the ribbon cable to remove it. Now to remove the disk drive. Located on the bottom, there are four Phillips screws that have to be removed. Once the four screws are removed, the disk drive is free. First, you will have to remove the ribbon cable to completely take the drive out. And that is the take apart guide for the Apple Lisa.